We've had a weird history with Vortex. The recent games we played on Vortex have actually been pretty good, even though Intel bought them out and are not accepting any new subscriptions at this point in time. But we did get our hands on playing the free-to-play version of PUBG Battlegrounds on Vortex, so let's see if it's worth playing. The first thing you should know is that loading PUBG is a pain in the butt on Vortex. Like we mentioned in our Path of Exile comparison video, loading takes a long time on Steam, upwards of 15 minutes, easy. Just when you think your download has been completed, it hits you with another loading screen. Shake my damn head. Now, Vortex has been known to not be the highest performing cloud gaming platform out there. Check our Vortex benchmark for full reference. So if you ever do get past the Steam loading screens, check the settings to see what Vortex sets the default graphics at. I'll also activate the Steam in-game FPS counter to get a good sense of what we're working with. Now before messing with anything else in the settings, make sure to set the render scale to 100 so that the game produces the visuals at 100% resolution. Vortex only displays video at 720p, so you'll need all the clarity possible. Now onto the graphics, and well, it's set to very low, as expected, on a game that was behind the curve in graphics to begin with. Shake my damn head. Now in-game, PUBG is actually very responsive since we're in the US and Vortex has various servers in country. Plus, even though the graphics are set at very low, the FPS stays pretty close to 60. You might have some hiccups here and there, but generally, it's pretty consistent. But this was my personal experience with it, and apparently, the team here has had a different experience entirely. Even with gigabit internet, you could be seeing this to this, all in one night, mind you. That's a wall there, buddy.
That's terrible.
So your experience might vary, just a forewarning. You can get kills, however, if you can see your target. Just look at it as an extra difficulty tier. Never mind if Vortex kicks you out of the game multiple times. Just ignore that, nothing to see here. Now what did we learn? Well, we learned that everyone's experience will be different on Vortex, unfortunately. Flip a coin and maybe things will go your way. Hopefully Vortex's new owners, Intel, will really increase the value of this platform soon. GeForce Now really needs US competition. Until then, make sure to like the video. Also, don't forget to subscribe to get the latest news, gameplay, and comparisons on cloud gaming at the only place where you can do battle in gaming heaven, Cloud Gaming Battle.